Hey everyone, you might have heard people talk about PCI Express riser cables, but what are they and do you need them? Well, the short answer is you might not need them unless you're doing like a small form factor build or you're actually like vertically mounting your GPU. But actually, let's back up a bit and discuss what riser cables are. So basically, you've got your PCI Express slots on your motherboard. They might be a full size, like, you know, x16 slot where you put your graphics card, or they might be a shorter one like x1 or x4. And you might put things like Wi-Fi cards or networking cards in those slots, or your graphics card, of course. But let's say, for example, your graphics card is really big and bulky. That might actually block some of the PCI Express slots, the other ones. So what you might be able to do is get a riser cable, put it in one of those other slots, and then that actually gives you another PCI Express slot elsewhere in your case, where you can then plug your other expansion cards into. So that's one common use case of riser cables, but you can actually use them with your graphics card too, and these are known as X16 riser cables, because basically that main slot that you put your graphics card into is PCI Express X16, meaning 16 lanes of bandwidth, and as a result, what you need is a big bulky cable to actually move that X16 slot somewhere else in your case. The problem though is because X16 is quite a lot of bandwidth, the actual riser cable is very bulky, as I just mentioned and as I just shown. And as a result, it's actually not easy to work with riser cables. So if you've got like just a random case which doesn't support vertically mounted GPUs, and I'll talk about that in a second, then actually if you just run out and buy a riser cable and you try and mount it in your case, it's probably not gonna fit. Like I tried that ages ago with an older micro ATX case, and actually the riser cable was just too big and bulky for the actual case. I think I actually only ordered like a 20 or 30 centimeter riser cable, but it was just too big regardless. So where are riser cables useful? I've already mentioned you can use them with X16 ones to actually move your graphics card, but who would actually need that? Well, firstly, if you're doing a small form factor build, the space is so limited inside the case that you often will need to actually position your graphics card somewhere else. So you might have your motherboard in one section of the build and then your graphics card in the other part of the case. In that case, what often happens is the mini ITX case includes a riser cable. So what would happen is you do your build and then you plug the riser cable one point into the motherboard, and the other point of the riser cable you actually clip your graphics card into, and then you mount that onto the case wherever that might be. And that is quite a common use case for X16 riser cables. The other people who might use them are for vertically mounting their GPU. So sometimes you see, especially on like TikTok and places like that, you actually see people who, instead of having the graphics card in the normal position facing downward, they actually vertically mount it. And I've actually got a Lianli LanCool 2 case that supports vertically mounted GPUs, unlike my really old micro ATX case that didn't support that. And as a result, what I could do is I could go to Lianli and I could buy a vertical GPU riser kit. What that actually includes is a metal bracket to actually position my graphics card somewhere else in my case, but it also includes an X16 riser cable. And then because my case supports that, I could actually have my graphics card instead of it facing downward, I could have it vertically mounted instead, and that can look a lot better, especially if you've got a windowed case or something like that. So hopefully that all makes sense. If you've got any further questions though, please let me know down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.